Here are some beginner-friendly audio tricks. If you just want to listen to a portion of your timeline because you want to work on the audio, you can press Option S and that will solo the audio of the media you selected. You can definitely see the difference. This is just an example, but anytime you record the audio externally, not with the camera you're shooting with, you would need to sync the audio in post. You're not gonna hear anything else from your timeline. Okay, you will not lose your sense of hearing. Now, if you wanna loop that audio, you can just press the slash key and check this out. You would need to sync the audio in post. You can definitely see the difference. This is just an example, but anytime you record the audio externally, now you can really work on this portion. All right, I can hear some of you guys are like, mine doesn't loop. We're gonna fix that. What I didn't tell you guys is that the slash key is actually a command to play the selected clip. And if you wanna loop it, you have to activate the loop on your timeline first. You can go to View, Playback, and Loop Playback. Or you can just press Command L, and then with your clip selected, now you can press the slash key and it will loop. I don't know if that was the right time for the intro. Nah, I actually wanted to show you guys, especially if you're a beginner, the power of using keyframes. You see these points right here? These are called keyframes, and basically they help you to make changes on a portion of a clip without affecting the entire clip. That's really cool, right? So from this point, I made the volume louder. The decibel is gradually changing. Now you can add these keyframes manually by pressing Option and you will see this plus sign right here. And if you click on this audio line, it will create a point or a keyframe. But the faster way to do it is to use the range tool. And man, this is probably one of the most powerful tools in Final Cut Pro. And to be honest with you guys, it deserves its own separate video. But this is how you use it. Press R and just click and drag at the location you want to select. And you will be able to adjust the volume of this portion right here without affecting the rest of the audio. And look at that. It also created those keyframes for you. Thank you, Range Tool. One last easy tip here. I have two clips from different angles right here, and I don't need the audio of this top clip. And just so you know, the audio of these clips are already synced. And if you missed that video on how to sync your audio, I'm gonna link it right here. But because I don't need this audio, I can drag this line all the way down to zero, or drag this slider up here in the inspector tab all the way down to zero, or better yet, I can just disable that audio by unchecking this box right here. And that audio channel of that clip won't bother me anymore. And that's it. If you guys got any value from this video, subscribe today and go check out these tips for Final Cut Pro users. And I will see you guys in the next one, hopefully. Peace.